Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we are going to talk about type coercion and data type symbol in JavaScript, and both are important. And symbol is something which is a new data type introduced with the latest version of JavaScript. So type coercion and what is this and how it is useful when we write code. And now we already know what is double equals and what is triple equals, so we'll correlate it with those examples that when type coercion is happening in JavaScript. So sometimes you feel like while writing it, okay, this is a weird part of JavaScript, how that is happening. But that is principally, that is true and happening for a particular reason. So when you do one triple equals, one double equals to true, then what do you think about it? So with double equal, one is coerced into being a boolean, which results this in a true, because one is considered as a true and it's a double equals, it's not comparing type, so it's actually a conversion of one into a boolean to make it as a true. Similarly, when you try to concat a two particular string or a number to a string, that there also type coercion is happening. We already know that it will be a string plus number, but how that is happening internally in JavaScript? Actually, this number will become a string when you doing a concat operation there. Okay, and type coercion is happening whenever you are actually putting any conditional statement. So either you put an object here, either you put a boolean, if it is a true, then obviously it will become a true. But any non-numeric value you are putting, any not null or not empty value you are putting, that means it will become a true. So there is also a coercion happening. It is converting that to true for these conditional code, like if, log, while, do while, or any kind of statement. Simple example with the object also, like object is considered as a not null. Then if you pass that object is not null, it is having some value. So it will be coerced to true. That means this statement is now true. Okay, same thing exists on array. Like you can just pass array which is not null. You can even pass the array index here, that will also not null. So because that will convert it to a true. But whenever simple example is this const array is there. So always remember this. I have a 0, 1, 2, 3. Now if I try to pass array of 0, right, and array of 0, if it is not non-zero value, then only it will become true, because 0 is considered as a false in JavaScript and that will be coerced to a true. And even if you just pass array, that will be true because this is an object. Okay, now talking about a symbol data type, and a symbol data type we can understand from a simple example. This primitive type is useful for unique keys. Like you create a map or a set. Set is also like storing the values, non-duplicate values. And we have a map also now in ES6 where you are storing the key value pair. A symbol is a data type or a primitive type. Okay, first of all, it's a primitive type. It's not holding an object reference or compound type. It's a primitive type. It is useful for called unique values. Using a symbol, you know, no one else who doesn't share this instance will not be able to set a specific property on a map. So this we will try to understand with an example. First, we are writing a vanilla JavaScript example code. Here we have a map. We have two methods, setProp and setProp2, and we are passing the same map. Okay. So what it is doing is, when you are calling setPropMap, it will override the prop property, and second one will override the prop to a hey version 2. So in this particular case, there is an override of values happening from the first one. However, with simple, instead of just using the string prop, we can use instance itself. Here we are using string, right? We can use instance itself. We can create a two symbol and we can set that in a particular map. So here we have a symbol 1 and symbol 2. And we can actually set map of symbol 1 and symbol 2 with some values. And here map of symbol 1 will hold 1 and map of symbol 2 will hold 2 and outcome will be 3. And if we talk about generally how symbol works, so the symbol function returns a value of type symbol, has static properties that exposes several members of Milton object. Okay, I mean, if you want to understand more about symbol as a new primitive type, then you can actually look at the MDN documentation. But symbol is actually a function that returns the value of type symbol, which has a static properties. Even when you try to do in JavaScript, symbol actually creates the unique objects. This will also become false. Okay. So this is all about JavaScript data types. Now in the next videos, we'll talk about some tricky JavaScript problems, which can be related to a simple object or null undefined functions and all.